Hello out there. Hello in here. Hello to our Second Life live studio audience and to those listening or watching a simulcast on venuma.com or listening on the web at theinfinitemind.com. Folks, this isn't radio. No, this is radio 6.0. That's right. This event is a first. I'm John Hockenberry. This is The Infinite Mind with the opening today of this virtual space. And it feels very real to all of us here. The Infinite Mind becomes the first national broadcast of any kind to establish an ongoing presence in a virtual world. That song actually ended up in music history a little bit as MP3s were being developed. Tell that story.
The story, as I heard it, is that, I was taking my daughter to school one day, and one of the children's parents said to me, congratulations on being the mother of the MP3. And I barely knew what an MP3 was at that point. This was a long time ago. And so I was said, what are you talking about?
And your child must have looked pretty alarmed.
She had already gone in. Yes, exactly. I mean, who was this other creature?
Yeah, my sibling, MP3. Wait a minute.
They gave me a link or something, or I think they might have actually given me the article, and the story was that the guy who developed the MP3, Karl-Heinz Brandenburg, was working on the MP3 in the late 1980s. He felt that he had taken it as far as he could go. He felt he had really refined it to the point that he was happy with it. And somewhere down the hallway, there was a song playing, and that was my original version of Tom's Diner, which was just my voice, a cappella. So he ran that song, that version of that song, through the MP3 and realized that he needed to refine it more because it was just the voice alone through it. And so then he realized he wasn't happy with it, so he used it to refine the MP3 further. And I'm not sure how long that took. It might have taken a year or something like that.
But it had a certain clarity and simplicity that allowed him to, you know,
to hear what he was doing.
But it also is complex because the human voice is complex. So when you get the voice right, probably a lot of other stuff is right as well.
I guess so. Yeah. And so the article concluded by saying, whenever you hear any kind of MP3 of any kind, what you're hearing is the result of Karl-Heinz Brandenburg's work and my voice. So therefore, that was what made me the mother of the MP3.
Well, Mom, let me just say, so glad to meet you.
Thanks.
But, you know, I don't need to hear that story to appreciate that song, Tom's Diner. Will you play it for us?
Sure.
Or sing it for us?
I will sing it for you right now, right here, the way it was originally written. I am sitting in the morning at the diner on the corner. I am waiting at the counter for the man to pour the coffee, and he fills it only halfway, and before I even argue, he is looking out the window at somebody coming in. It is always nice to see you, says the man behind the counter to the woman who has come in. She is shaking her umbrella, and I look the other way as they are kissing their hellos, and I'm pretending not to see them, and instead I pour the milk. I open up the paper. There's a story of an actor who had died while he was drinking. It was no one I had heard of. And I'm turning to the horoscope and looking for the funnies when I'm feeling someone watching me. And so I raise my head. There's a woman on the outside looking inside. Does she see me? No, she does not really see me, 'cause she sees her own reflection. And I'm trying not to notice that she's hitching up her skirt, and while she's straightening her stockings, her hair has gotten wet. Oh, this rain, it will continue through the morning as I'm listening to the bells of the cathedral. I am thinking of your voice and of the midnight picnic once upon a time before the rain began. And I finish up my coffee, and it's time to catch the train.
Oh man, that was great. Thank you so much. And I'm grinning ear to ear, seems to be the serious reaction
Okay.
from the